is one of our first projects that comes from overall study of the city.
City engineers led a project to preserve Cottonwood Creek and two neighborhood ponds, plus create more of a destination to exercise and enjoy nature.
A lot of the residents, I think, are really excited for the trail loop. It's really nice to have this park, this kind of oasis, you know, a nice calm location.
But part of that relaxing spot was eroding. When it rained, storm waters would rush through the creek from Legacy Drive to Teal Parkway, flooding the ponds and causing the banks to erode.
We didn't want to lose the creek and the ponds.
We did a citywide creek investigation where we went out and looked and tried to figure out where the worst problems are and how to fix them, to kind of prioritize from the whole city's perspective which ones to do first.
So what we basically are doing is we're restoring the creek banks and the ponds back to what they were naturally, the creek banks naturally, to try to help control that erosion so that we can maintain our ponds and the creek.
The project involves filling large baskets with rock called grade controls, which will be buried under the bed of the creek. The cages will prevent the rocks from washing away to help maintain the creek. Plus,
we've repurposed old concrete barriers and have put those in the creek. And what that does is it redirects the floodwaters away from the banks to help control the erosion, and that will protect our infrastructure that's in the bank.
Crews are also installing this green reinforcement mat along the creek bank. The mat hugs the dirt to keep it in place. But the project includes more than reducing erosion.
This one really turned out to be a good one to do first because there's a number of different infrastructure at risk, including sewer, reuse line, the park, the Teal Bridge, some of the trail. There's quite a bit that's threatened.
The project will also build a walking loop around the West Pond and a boardwalk over a spillway between the two ponds.
We'd like to keep the natural look of the park. There's a lot of wildlife that comes here. There's a lot of fishing opportunities with the park. We're adding an additional fishing pier that's going to be ADA compliant for residents. Adding the loop, I think, is going to help bring them kind of more in with nature.
Not only are we fixing a major problem, but we're preventing other major problems from occurring. So it's a good use of funds for a first project, and it's one that we're really excited about.
The project costs roughly $3.4 million. Costs are covered by stormwater utility and parks fees. Engineers hope construction is complete by this summer.
I think a lot of people are excited that we're getting to, that we're doing the work to keep the ponds in place so they can come back out and enjoy the nature once it's done.